In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the repeater with a very simple but powerful expression that you'll definitely want to remember. I'm also going to show you how to use loopOut offset to get the ticking movement you're seeing now. Though this is a very simple design, the techniques you'll learn can be used in a variety of ways that will speed up your workflow and give your animation a more advanced feel. Stick around, you don't want to miss this episode. Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, is guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project file for this episode are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's right-click in the area that's to the left of our timeline and choose New Shape Layer. Open up that shape layer and go to our Add button, and we're just going to add in a group. And then within that group, let's add in an ellipse and a stroke. So let's open up our properties here, and let's just increase this ellipse size like that, and maybe increase our stroke to about, say, 7 pixels. And then let's just call this group Outer Rim. Go back to Contents and add in another group. Now make sure you're on Contents and not Outer Rim, because watch, if I add a group in at this level, it adds it in within the Contents, whereas if I have Outer Rim selected and go to Group, it will add it within Outer Rim. We don't want to do that. So let's close it back up, click on Contents, add another group, and let's just call this Ticks. Within this Ticks group, we're going to add in a rectangle, and then let's add in a fill. Okay, now let's change this fill color to white. And then open up our settings here, and for rectangle path, let's unconstrain our X and Y size values and just make the X value 15, and then the Y value, we'll make that say 50. So we have a small little tick there. And then I'm gonna increase my roundness, so it's got rounded edges, as we can see right there. Within this ticks group, let's add in the repeater. So once we open up the repeater, we can see there are some default settings. So moving forward, we'll be affecting 4 properties. The first thing will be the position of our rectangle path, the number of copies within the repeater, the position of our repeater, make sure you're in the transform properties of repeater, and the rotation. First, let's make our number of copies. So we need 12 ticks to represent each hour. Set our position to 0, 0. So that way everything is on top of each other, as we can see right here. And then for rotation, this is a very, very useful expression. Let's option or alt click on rotation, and we want to type 360, because that's how many degrees are in a circle, divided by, and then take this pick whip. This is your expression pick whip, and pick whip up to copies. And I'll explain why we want to do that in a second, instead of just 360 divided by 12. And then all we have to do is just simply move up our position of our rectangle path, and now we can move those into place. Now, the reason why I said to do this expression 360 divided by and then pick whip the number of copies, instead of having 12, you could have 4 that represent every 15 minutes, and it will continue to keep these in a circle. And you can change this value to anything. You can make it 6, and it will evenly space them out. For any reason you want to make 10, you could do that. We're going to keep ours at 12. Add in one more group, so go to Contents, add in a group, and we're going to call this Hand. And I'm just going to do one hand for this example, mainly because I want to focus on the loop out offset expression, which is the focus of this tutorial and one of the main things I really want to show. Okay, so within hand, we're going to add in a rectangle. I'm going to add in a fill, and again, change that to white, and then open up our rectangle path settings and unconstrain these size values. And again, let's make this 10 pixels wide, and then tall, we'll make it 400. So we get this little bit of an arm like that, and then let's just round this out. Since this is 400 pixels tall, we need to move our position up negative 200 pixels, because we're going to go up half the distance, and that will keep our anchor point at the bottom of this hand here. Look, maybe we can go a little bit thicker, we'll say 15. Okay, so now we want to use the transform properties of this hand to animate this. So now see, as we start to move this rotation, we can see that this hand is moving around our clock. The way I've always done this in the past is I've used a time expression. So alt click on rotation, you can type time times 25 and just have the hand move in that way. But I've actually found a much more useful way of doing this. So let's take that off by Option Alt clicking and then Option Alt click again. And we're going to type in loop out. And if you notice, I'm getting some suggestions from After Effects. I believe starting in 2020, After Effects started to add this feature in where if you start to type an expression, it will give you some suggested options. If you're using a version of After Effects that's older, you may not see this. So just make sure that you type this expression exactly the way that I'm typing it. Loop out with a lowercase L, capital O, open parenthesis, and then we're going to do quotation and then type in offset and make sure you close those out. So you can see After Effects already does that for me. So now we have a warning, that's because we don't have any keyframes yet. So let's put a keyframe for rotation at the beginning of our animation. Let's go forward maybe 10 frames. And now we want to go forward 1 second, 360, because it's 360 degrees in a circle, divided by how many seconds are in a minute, which is 60. And so that gives us 6 degrees. And as you can see, our arm moved. So now if we watch this play back, we can see that we get basically the same effect that we got whenever we were using the time expression. The thing that's kind of cool about this is that you have more control over this. So instead of increasing the speed, like if I did time times 25, I could change it to time times 50, time times 10, any amount to make it slower or faster. We can just move these keyframes further and closer apart to get the same effect, but to get it in a much quicker way. But we can also do even more of that. So I'm going to move this keyframe back to the 10th frame, and then I'm going to go forward maybe 5 frames, so we're at the 15th frame here. Copy this last keyframe, copy paste, so that way these two values are identical. Our rotation starts, goes to 6 degrees, hangs there, and because of the loop out offset expression, it's going to repeat this 6 degree rotation animation indefinitely. So we watch that play back. See, it goes forward and kind of stops and then keeps going. Maybe we're gonna put a little bit more distance here and I'm going to spread this out so we can see more of it. As we can see, it looks like the clock is ticking 1 second at a time, ticking and then holding and ticking and then holding. Loop out offset subtracts the ending value from the starting value of your animation, and it applies that difference to the final keyframe. So we have 6 degrees between these first two keyframes. As we can see, this is at 0, go to the 10th frame, and we have 6 degrees. If we go to the 20th frame and say move this keyframe back here, we're still at 6 degrees. So by this rationale, when we get to the 1 second mark, we should be at 12 degrees. And if we click there, we see that we are. Now, one of the other things that we can do is we can change these keyframes to hold keyframes by selecting all of them, right click and choose toggle hold. Now see the result when we watch it play back, it jumps forward 1 second and then it continues moving on in that direction. And again, you can slow this down if you want to be exactly 1 second. We can move these keyframes down so that way it will move in 1 second increments. We see it jumps forward, waits a second, and then it continues on after that indefinitely. If you want something that's a little bit quicker, again, you can move these a lot closer together, and then that's the result that we get. And you can also jump forward even further. So let's change this middle keyframe here. See, we moved it forward 1 second. Well, let's type in 360 divided by 12. So that way it's going to jump forward 5 seconds. And now if we copy this keyframe and paste it to the third keyframe, this will jump forward in 5 second increments. And again, you can slow this down by spreading these keyframes out. And we can also change these back to linear or even make them Bezier. So let's say we make these Bezier. So we'll make these easy ease instead and then watch this play back. So it goes forward 5 seconds and then it stops and then it continues on. So this is just one of many examples using loop out offset that we'll be taking a look at. It's a very powerful expression and I highly recommend you experiment with it. The easiest way of grasping exactly what this expression does is to remember that whatever values you have between your keyframes, this expression will take the difference between those and then repeat them forever, whether it's position, scale, rotation, opacity, or some other value that you have keyframed. And this is just a loop out version of offset. There's also a loop in version, which is a whole other tutorial. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.